Hi guys, I'm Steph Prescott. Some of you may know me, some of you may not. A couple of years ago, mga 2007, nag-start ako sa showbiz. Those of you who do know me know that I joined Starstruck in 2007. Kabatch ko sila Chris Bernal, Alger Abrenica, Jewel Mish. And I also did commercial modeling before that.
Why is Skin White number one in whitening? You see real results.
I was in showbiz for 8 years until I got pregnant with my first son. I was 21 years old. Medyo nag-stop ng bigla yung career ko, and I focused on being a mom na and a wife. Since then, I had another son, and he is currently 2 years old right now. In short, tumaba ako ng sobra. I gained so much weight during my pregnancies. I even was on the cover of FHM before, and that is, of course, no more na. I'm working on getting healthy again. It's not really gonna be a journey for too much na pa-sexy, pero the main focus is going to be on how I become healthy again. So I started my journey when I gave birth to my first son. That was like 6 years ago, almost 7 years ago. And I've been always restarting and starting and starting again my journey. So I think some of you may be able to relate to that. Yung magsistart kayo magpapayat, magsistart kayo on your fitness journey. And then of course, life happens, you become busy. So work, whatever it is, sa school, taking care of the kids if you're a mom like me. Minsan nangyayari talaga yun, na you stop progressing, you give up, and then you have to restart again. But sometimes it's nakakatakot. If you're like me, parang your old body seems way too far from where you are now. I originally was 120 pounds when I was in show business. And with my first son, after giving birth, I was 198 pounds. And I thought that was crazy. I thought I would never reach 200. But after my second baby, I was a whopping 220 pounds. That's a drastic change. It didn't happen overnight, of course, so I don't expect my journey going back down to be overnight as well. It took many years of neglecting myself, many years of not taking care of myself to get to this weight. And of course, I'm not at that weight anymore. I did start my journey again. So always starting my journey over and over again. But I did, and hopefully this time it sticks, because I've learned a lot along the way. I found what works for me, and I hope to share that with most of you guys. So if you guys are on the same journey as me, or you guys are thinking about starting your weight loss journey, hopefully I can help you with the tips that I'm going through and the tips that I use para gumana sa akin yung pagpapapayat ko. Being moms, we always have to give time for others. Nauna lagi yung anak natin, nauna yung husbands natin, na set aside talaga tayo.
Lens ka pa! Lens ka!
Say mama.
Mama.
Say papa.
Papa.
Are you gonna help mommy make dinner for you? Apa? Apa? Okay, let's make dinner.
I'm not blaming, of course, my children dahil blessing sila, and I don't regret having any of them, because it's given me a learning experience na incomparable. Of course, everyone's journey is gonna be different. Your starting point is gonna be different as well. Gusto kong mag-start lagi ng fitness journey. This time, I really wanted to. I was super in the right mindset na gusto ko talaga. Not for the look of my body, but for my health-wise. Like from within, yung health from within. And then all of a sudden, one Sunday, so I was in BGC with my husband, and I was walking down the stairs with my youngest son. And then, split second, nawala yung footing ko sa stairs, and I ended up breaking my ankle and my fibula. On the back of our leg, we have this like super nipis na bone na yun yung fibula.
Dislocated talaga, mommy. Dislocated, no? Ayun, mommy. Maganda ka pa rin, mommy.
So I shattered it. And that was the craziest day of my life. So anyways, ayun. From being normal, all of a sudden, hindi ako makalakad. I can't move anything in my leg sa left side. And you can't do anything but stay in bed.
Day after the operation today, and I'm kind of manas with all the fluids that I'm getting.
So mentally, I'm super proud of myself for being strong enough mentally na hindi ako nagpa-apekto masyado, hindi ako na-depressed or anything. But I tried to look at the situation as a positive. And something wonderful about that experience was actually learning how much I take my body for granted. I was in bed for 2 months. Higa lang. Tumatayo ako para umihi lang, but I have to have crutches all the time. This was before the lockdown happened, so maraming tao na nasa labas, naiinggit ka. Hindi pa normal ang nasa bahay ka lang. So sa akin, sabi ko, is this really something that I want to continue living with? Na parang kinailangan akong ibaldado ni Lord para ma-appreciate ko yung katawan ko. Para maisip ko na I want to be taking better care of myself. So I swore to myself, I said, once I start walking again, hindi na ako magpapabaya sa sarili ko. I'm really gonna put more effort because I really believe that this happened for a reason. Everything happens for a reason. Yan yung paniniwala ko. I really believe that if you are doing something na stubborn ka, the Lord will literally teach you the hard way. So yun ang nangyari sa akin. I do believe that God allowed my leg and my ankle to break because He wanted to teach me something. Thank God that I actually recovered my ankle and my leg a month before expected. I did get surgery and I do have titanium in my leg now and it's gonna be there for life, but it's always also gonna be a constant reminder na this is something na hindi siya end goal yung iniisip ko. I'm not gonna think about being 120 pounds and that's the only goal. It's not. I do believe that a fitness journey is a lifestyle change. The most that you learn and the most enjoyable part of it is actually the day-to-day during the journey. When I started walking again, of course, nag-lockdown. So, I was 2 months in bed and then all of a sudden, kahit makalakad na ako, hindi pa rin ako makalabas ng bahay kasi nagkaroon ng COVID naman. And that even opened my eyes even more to how important our health is. Since walang gym, everyone was inside, I thought of ways how to stay active even just in the house. And I said to my husband, I think I want to get like a spinning bike or a stationary bike para hindi siya masyadong mabigat sa paa ko because I am still very heavy. I was at 220 pounds and trying to start walking again on a previously broken bone. 220 pounds is a really like a lot of load already. That was my number one fear, was to break it again. We ended up buying a stationary bike and from then on, I've been on it every single day.
Yeah, yeah. So we got the spinning bike. Those of you who don't know, on Feb 9th, I broke my leg, my fibula and ankle. And so I've been waiting for this moment for a while now when I can finally start working out again.
Mommy, you're soapy up. Let's go. Let's get this done and over with, bro. Come on, bro. No quitting.
So, no more excuses. No more excuses.
Since I broke my leg until now, it has been 3 months. But since walking again, it has been a little over a month. So far, I've lost 42 pounds or 19 kilos. That is a huge difference. I don't recommend losing your weight that fast, but I think a lot of it was water retention as well. So it wasn't all fat. So I am 178 pounds as of the moment. I still have a ways to go and I want you guys to be on that journey with me. So of course, I want to be as transparent as I can in these videos. I'll show you guys what I do to work out. I'll show you guys what I eat. I hope you guys really can also inspire me in the comment section below. If you guys have stories or tips of your own as well, I'd love to hear about them. I'm really looking forward to making this into a community of moms, even if you're not moms, of women or men. I'm open to everyone. I hope we inspire each other. And also in the comments, please be nice to each other. So I hope you guys stay positive all the time. Looking forward to talking with you guys again.